All right, now I want to talk about paintings that I did along the Amalfi Coast. In a previous video, I spoke about the village of Positano, where we visited several times before we actually spent a month living there. And Positano is one of the major town villages on the Amalfi Coast. As I mentioned, the Amalfi Coast, it stretches from the Gulf of Naples near Sorrento to the Gulf of Salerno. And there is some, probably along the Amalfi Coast, is about 12, 13 beautiful little towns and villages, including the town of Amalfi. There's only one main road which goes from Positano to Vietro sul Mare. It's about 25 miles up along the cliffs. It's a pretty beautiful ride, a little scary. But we spent a lot of time just taking the boats and the ferries between the towns. It's probably a 20-minute ferry between Positano and Amalfi. And this is where I did several paintings. Once again, these were done while I was in Positano. Some were done, but mostly the ones we're going to talk about now were done from sketches and photos because I didn't bring a canvas on the ferry. So the first one like to talk about is this painting. It's called the Emerald Grotto. It's along the Amalfi Coast. It's in Italian, it's Grotto della Smeraldo. And it's just you can just look at this. It's a spectacular grotto. And it was discovered by a man named Luigi Boncori back in 1932. At one point, the entrance was pretty much submerged, and it was hard to find this. This is, again, on the Tyrrhenian Sea on the coast, and there are many, many caves sort like this in Italy and actually in throughout the world. But the emerald light, the blue emerald light that you see inside is determined by the very unique lightning that concerns that particular cave. And this cave here, if you go inside, it's probably it's about 75 feet high, which we took a little boat inside there. And but this painting, I like it a lot because again, the composition is very unique. We have the very strong mountain on the left, which is sort of very pastelish, and this one is sort of my imagination because it was during the day when I did the photography and the sketches. But when I came back and painted this at my studio in Positano, I really had a lot of fun contrasting the mountains in the background, the cliffs. One set over on the right, very dark purples and maroons and magenta, and the other on the left, all these kind of very soft yellows, pinks, rose, and then I bring down into the pretty realistic field and the green trees and the sienna colored field. And then we drop down to the cliff, the mountain, little rocks in the bottom part of the cliff. And this was an interesting painting in the sense that there's a lot of, over on the left in the very pastel colors, it's mostly all palette knife from the left to the middle. Then over to the right, the purplish cliffs are done very strong brushstrokes. But the overall composition, to me, it was just a lot of fun. And again, what I do in a lot of these cliff paintings, and I did here, as you can see, I almost, I mute the sea. I mean, I have this little soft blue aqua emerald sea, but in comparison to the brushstrokes of the rest of the painting, they're very mild. But once again, the composition, I think, really works. Very colorful. It's 24 by 32. It is in the collection of Steve Hutchinson and Brenda Patton from Sarasota, Florida. Okay, now continuing on one of our little boat rides along the coast. In the vicinity of the Emerald Grotto was this beautiful tower. These towers were built back in the 1200s, 1300s, and supposedly to watch out for the Turkish fleet and other kinds of pirates coming into the area. Now, this painting is significant and different from the others because I played more with the more earth tone colors of the rocks than I did in the previous painting, which was very pastel and sort of contrasting with a lot of the violet. Now the tops of this, the cliffs on the top are that sort of violet magenta color, and then again below that is the, I have one of the cliffs with a bunch of grass and growth on it. But the main part of the painting is the big stones in back of the tower and in front of the tower, and they're very sort of earth tone colors and a lot of almost Tuscan. But the interesting thing, I had finished, I did all of these paintings at Positano, and it was before I had really got into my Tuscan scenes. But these colors really work together, in my opinion. They're very kind of, they blend with each other. There's a little, the nice white of the tower with the shade of the violet going against the dark grains of the trees. And then again, the, once again, a lot of these paintings, I make the Tyrrhenian Sea sort of soft. There's not a lot of brushwork in them, but it does smooth out, and I think within the composition, because there's some serious, if you take a look at the stone, the big rock that's sort of whitish and brownish in the back, there's a ton of brushwork and palette knife, and you can see the, you can actually see the strokes even on this photo. Anyway, another one from the area. This also is a vertical 24 by 32, and it's called Il Tower Amalfi. Now in this painting, we got really, really close up because this is a famous little spot on the coast, and it's called the Ponte Naturale, the natural bridge. That's just the way that the water had formed this little bridge going from the left into the right into the giant rock on the right, and it covers an entrance to sort of an unknown grotto. I'm not sure if it ever had a name, but this painting is really a lot of fun. Again, a lot of palette knife work in the background, but I'm mixing these colors up in the cliff in the back. There's almost some rose colors mixed in with the green of the trees and the yellow. Then we contrast, there's a lot of white. There's more white in this painting than in almost any of my paintings. So, and a lot of the white is done with a palette knife, and it balances against the soft yellows, which gives it the contours, it gives it its shape, it gives it depth. And it really makes it, and it makes it very harmonious because you can see, you can almost feel the curvature, particularly on the big rock on the right, where you're looking at it, and it sort of just starts, blends into that violet color before it hits the ocean. And the underside of the natural bridge, that dark color, which gives it the little shading before it enters the little entrance there in the back cliff. But in my opinion, a wonderful composition, and also I don't want to compete with the architecture of the stones and the cliffs. That's why I make the water a little softer color. But in this painting, it's stronger than most, and you also see some very strong brush strokes and some mixtures here. It's just not like a consistent blue. There is some yellows and greens and some violets, and particularly where the bridge is shading the water. But this is one painting that of the whole group from Positano, and I enjoyed doing a lot more than most of them, and it was so, it's different. You know, it really is a different architecture. You just don't see things like this very often. This painting is 20 by 24 inches. Okay, I'm not sure if I would call this my magnus opus from all the time I spent in Positano and the Amalfi Coast, but it's right up there. This is a majestic endeavor. Basically, from sketches that I had done and photos, I finished this painting back at Florence. This was not finished in Positano. It's a massive, it's 60 by 72 inches. And I still have this in my private collection because it was probably a major impact on my whole painting career, even though it was early on in Italy. It was in the second year of my 20 years there. But this, it's a very substantial work. And essentially it's the Tower of Erci, or Torre la Cerniola, Cerniola. Erke is one of these other beautiful villages. It's probably another 15, 20 minutes from the boat from Amalfi, and Amalfi being like 15, 20 minutes from Positano. But once again, there's just so many incredibly beautiful spots. And this, I spent a great deal of time working on because there is so much in it. And sort of like, it's supposedly, the tower was supposedly built in memory of Hercules, or even some people say it was designed by Hercules, but it was built in like 1278, 1280. But when I got back to the studio, this combines almost everything that I saw when I was there with all my painting outside. But if we just start at the top and look at the cliffs and look at the shapes and look at the colors, and you can see at the top left, you can see sort of the light from the sun in contrasting with the dark as we move in. And then again, over to the middle on the right, there's more lighting. But there's a lot of this in and out with the cliffs. Also at the top of the trees in the middle there, you see the lighting. And then, of course, the little houses in the village. And then we come to the tower itself. And there's a lot of paint. The tower itself is pretty much all brushwork, but a lot of the rocks on the sea are a combination of the brushwork and some palette knife work. And definite palette knife work in the background of the mountains. And again, the composition, you have to be careful when you're doing something this enormous that you don't, you know, first of all, there's perspective to think about. And then with these little inlets, if you notice, there's the stones and the big rocks in the front, but then we over to the left, we go around the corner and there's another inlet, and that leads almost to another one in the back area of the third group of trees. So I'm very proud of this work. When I brought it back and was working on it in Florence, my former teachers, Rose and Claire, they started comparing it to my, Rose said something like, well, you're studying your Cézanne. And then sure enough, this quote on the bottom, we had this, this was in my second show, I'm sorry, my third show in New York in 2004. And the New York art critic, David Cleveland, who at the time was working for Art News and an independent critic, also an author, very well respected author about tonalism. And he, this is his quote, essentially. And what, sure enough, he's got the same reference to Cézanne. Il Castello Amalfi is a triumphant Cézanne-esque summation of Kelley's preoccupation with man-made architecture and natural form. This soaring vertical composition is a tour de force of layered and complex planes reigning in majesty over a blue sea. And I thought that was a very positive and strong comment about the painting. It's once again, it's 60 by 72 inches. It's in my studio in Sarasota, Florida, in my private collection. And that will wrap up the paintings on the Amalfi Coast. And our next talk will be about the paintings at Capri and Ischia.